Hey there, I am Mrinal and welcome to NFC for Beginners video series. In today's video, we will be talking about how NFC actually works in Android. So let's get started. NFC works in three modes. The first one is card recognition mode. And this mode is used when your smartphone is interacting with NFC payment support system. For example, when you are making a payment using your NFC phone. And the second mode is peer-to-peer mode. Well, this mode is used when your smartphone is interacting with another active smartphone. For example, when you are sharing a link using your smart NFC in your smartphone to another phone having the NFC. And the last mode is read-write mode. This mode is used when your smartphone is interacting with another passive device. For example, a coupon code or an NFC tag. You might be thinking that NFC works by sending and receiving radio signal like Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. And you are right in that. But how exactly does it work and what is the actual logic behind its working? Let's find out. The basic principle on how NFC works is based upon the phenomenon of inductive coupling. Now guys, if you don't know what inductive coupling is, don't worry, I will be explaining it to you. All the NFC-based smartphones have a special hardware built into the back of the devices. So let's assume that this is your smartphone, and considering that this is the back panel of your smartphone, it has a special hardware built into it. The hardware has a coil of wire, and when the electricity is passed through that coil of wire, a magnetic field is generated around it. So if we zoom into this portion, it will look something like this. These are the coil of wire in the hardware. I will be showing it to you in the practical demonstration after this. So these are the coil of wire, and whenever the electricity is passed through this coil of wire, a magnetic field will be generated. And let's assume that these are the magnetic field. Okay, so now whenever a secondary coil, in our case it is an NFC tag, is placed inside this magnetic field, the electricity will be induced in that secondary coil. So let's assume that this is our NFC tag. And this NFC tag is placed inside the magnetic field of the smartphone. So what will happen is, it will induce electricity due to the magnetic field, and it will start transmitting the information which has stored in it. And this is why the NFC tags are also called passive RFID tags. It's called passive because you have seen in the previous example that NFC tags don't have the power supply of their own, but they derive energy from the nearby object. And the RFID tags, because an NFC tag is a subcategory of RFID tags. So if these are the RFID tags, a subset will be NFC tags. So the best example of RFID tags will be one that you see for tracking animals or for tracking the shipments. And NFC tags are a little bit different because NFC tags are only passive in nature. That is, they derive energy or power from the nearby object and they don't have their own power supply. Now let me just show you practically how NFC works using my Android tablet and some of the NFC tags. So what happens is, when your device is unlocked, NFC gets turned on automatically, and if it doesn't turn on, you can go to its setting and do that manually. But by default, the NFC is turned on as you just unlock your device. Now you see that NFC is turned on. Now it's transmitting a magnetic field around it, all over and around it at the range of 4 cm. So what happens is, now once the NFC tags come inside this magnetic field, electricity will be induced inside this NFC tag. And let me just place it, and I have programmed this NFC tag to pair to a Bluetooth, so it will say this. If I get another NFC tag and place it inside the magnetic field of this device, you will see that it says NFC tag detected with its ID.
Now, whenever this NFC tags come inside the magnetic field of this devices, the information stored in it is sent directly to the devices. For practically that, it says that the distance is 10 cm, but I have found out that it won't work more than 4 cm, and the speed varies from 100 to 400 kilobits per second. But now, if you open the device, let me just pause the video for you. Now, after I remove the back of this Android tablet, you can see that this is a coil for the transmission to take place. And if I remove this and then bring this NFC tag in contact, you see nothing will happen.